Okay, so good morning, everyone. This is a sixth lecture session of the course Engineering Computational Fluid Dynamics. So in our previous lecture, we have started our discussion on the approximation of partial differential equations into algebraic set of equations. And in particular, we have started dealing with the individual partial derivative term. And we are trying to see what are the difference finite difference schemes available for these transformations and what is the order of accuracy of these individual schemes. Okay, so if you recall, we have already discussed about the forward and backward difference scheme for first order derivative term, and we have also talked about central difference scheme on and all these discussion we have done on uniform grid, and we found that for the approximation of first order derivatives, forward and backward difference schemes are first order accurate, whereas the central difference scheme is second order accurate. Okay. Apart from that, we have also dealt with the second order derivative, and that particularly we discussed about central difference scheme. Okay. Now, here comes one important issue. As I told you that in our governing equations, mainly we are having highest order up to the second order only. Okay, but apart from that, we are having one more term which actually involves mixed derivatives. Okay, so we are having some terms which involve del square u divided by del x del y. So this type of derivatives are nothing but called as mixed derivatives. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to devise some way to discretize our mixed derivative terms, or in other words, I can say we have to devise some ways to find the finite difference approximations for mixed derivative terms. Okay, so let me talk about this. So first, what I'll be doing, considering the Taylor series expansion, I will be writing u at point I plus 1 comma j with reference to point I comma j. So this is something which I have done yesterday also, u I j plus del u by del x at point I comma j into delta x plus del square u divided by del x square at point I comma j times delta x square divided by 2 factorial plus del cube u divided by del x cube. Okay, and that also we have to determine at I comma j delta x cube divided by 3 factorial plus so on up to like this. Okay. So now what I will do, because if you see in the definition of mixed derivative, what we are having del square u by del x del y. Okay. So I have one term on the right hand side, which include del u by del x. So if I have to make this term del square u by del x del y, what I have to do, this entire equation, I have to differentiate with del by del y. Okay, so what I will be doing now, because I want to get this mixed derivative term. So if I have to get this mixed derivative term, what I have to do, I have to take the differentiation of this entire equation with reference to y. So what I can write, if I differentiate this entire equation, I'll be able to get del u by del y at point I plus 1 comma j, that will be equal to del u by del y at point I comma j plus, over here we will be getting del square u by del x del y at point I comma j times delta x, okay, plus del cube u divided by del, so it will be del x square into y. Okay, this is also we are calculating at point I comma j into del x square divided by 2 factorial plus so on up to like this. Okay, so now this is about this del square u by del x del y term. Okay, so now if you just try to find out this term by neglecting all the higher order terms, so these I am considering as all my higher order terms. So if I neglect all the higher order terms, and if I try to find out this value of del square u by del x del y at point I comma j, that will be becoming del square u divided by del x del y at point I comma j will become del u by del y at point I plus 1 comma j minus del u by del y at point I comma j divided by delta x. Okay, because we have to calculate this term, so I will be dividing throughout by delta x, plus I will be having these terms as neglected. So what order of accuracy I will be getting? I will be getting order of accuracy as nothing but order of delta x, because I have divided by delta x. Yeah, Vinay, is there any doubt?
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay. So now what will be happening? If you see over here, so I am trying to calculate del square u by del x del y at point I comma j, and while calculating, so I am considering the point at I plus 1 and at I. So it means I am considering that point itself and one point on the right hand side of this particular point. Okay, so that's why what I can call this type of approximation as forward difference approximation. Okay, so I can call this as forward difference approximation. Now let me also substitute these del u by del y and del u by del y at point I plus 1 comma j and I comma j. Let me now approximate these with the finite differences which we are already knowing. Okay, so now I have two options. Either I can substitute this one with the central difference scheme, or I can substitute with the forward difference scheme. Okay, so what I will be doing, because already my overall equation is carrying order delta x, so that's why if I want to be consistent in terms of order of accuracy, so I will try to substitute these del u by del y terms with forward difference scheme only, which itself is a first order accurate. Okay, so if I do this, I will be getting mixed derivative del square u divided by del x del y at point I comma j as equal to, so what we are having, first term we are having del u by del y at point I plus 1 comma j. Okay, so if we are having at I plus 1 comma j, so considering forward difference approximation, what I can write, can you tell me? I can write u at point
u I plus 1 j plus 1 minus u I plus
yes, u I write I plus 1 j plus 1 minus u I plus
u
1
I plus 1 j
divided by
delta y
minus of u I comma j plus 1 minus u I comma j divided by delta y, and overall what we are having in the denominator, we have delta y plus we are getting order of delta x. Okay, so if you see, finally I can get from here u at point I plus 1 comma j plus 1. Okay, and then if you see these two points, this I will be getting then minus u at point I plus 1 comma j, then I will be getting minus u at I comma j plus 1, and minus will become plus, so plus u I j divided by delta y square. And this actually, now what I have done, I have replaced these terms in terms of y, so I can say that my order of accuracy is nothing but delta x comma delta y. In x also I have first order, and in y also I have first order accurate. Okay, so this I can call as the forward difference approximation of our mixed derivative. So now if I have to increase the order of accuracy, what I have to do? Okay, so sir, if I have to increase the order of accuracy, I have to go for the central difference approximation. So how to determine central difference approximation for this mixed derivative?
Hello, sir.
So what I'll be doing now, if you see, this is my first equation which I have considered in the forward direction, and I have taken its derivative with reference to y. Okay, so let me call this as, say, equation number 1. Now what I will be doing, I will be considering one more equation in the backward direction. So if I take in backward direction, it will be I minus 1 comma j, that will be equal to u at point I comma j plus minus of delta x times del u by del x, okay, plus minus of delta x whole square by 2 factorial into del square u by del x square, and these we are calculating at point I comma j, plus so on up to. Now what I will be doing, I have, because I have to obtain the mixed order derivative term. So if I have to obtain mixed order derivative, I have to differentiate this equation with y. So if I differentiate with y, it will be del u by del y at point I minus 1 comma j, and that will be equal to del u by del y at point I comma j, and it will become minus delta x del square u by del x del y at point I comma j, okay, and then I'll be having plus del x square by 2 factorial into del square u divided by del x, sorry, it will be del cube u divided by del x square into del y at point I comma j, plus so on up to, okay. So let me call this as my equation number 2. Now what I have to do, I have to determine this del square u by del x del y. So if I have to determine del square u by del x del y, considering equation number 1 and equation number 2, what I have to do? If you see over here, this term is positive and this term is negative. So which operation I have to apply?
Subtraction.
Can you tell me?
Subtraction.
So if I take 1 minus 2, I will be finding in the left hand side. Yeah.
Sir, in the last page, there was a mistake in the above term. Yes. Sir, it should be delta x in the denominator.
Okay. Just let me see. Oh, yeah. It will be delta x delta y. Yes.
And above also.
Yes. 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 Yeah. Thanks for correcting. Okay. Yeah, this will be delta, because earlier it was delta x in the previous slide. So it will be delta x delta y over here. Okay. So now what we are doing, we are applying this operation 1 minus 2. So if I do 1 minus 2, what I'll be getting? Del u by del y at point, which point? I plus 1 comma j minus del u by del y at which point? I minus 1 comma j, and that will be equal to 2 times delta x of del square u divided by del x del y, and then second term will be cancelling out. Is this point clear? Second, next term that will be cancelling out, and then finally I will be finding plus 2 times delta x cube divided by 3 factorial into del 4x divided by del x cube del y. Is this point clear? How I have got this term? Okay, so plus.
Yes, sir.
So now what we have to do? This is our higher order term. So this higher order term we will be neglecting. So from here, if I calculate now del square u by del x del y at point I comma j, so it will be nothing but this del u by del y at point I plus 1 comma j. So now what I will be doing at this point, I will be applying which scheme? Central difference scheme, because now we are moving towards second order accurate scheme. So if I apply second order accurate, what I can write? U at point I plus 1 comma j plus 1 minus u at point I plus 1 comma j minus 1 divided by 2 times of delta y. Is this point clear? Minus, I have to write del u by del y at point I minus 1 comma j. Okay, so this if I write, I can write u at I minus 1 comma j plus 1 minus u at I minus 1 comma j minus 1 divided by 2 delta y. Okay, and in the entire denominator, we will be having 2 times of delta x, because these two times of delta x we have to divide throughout. Okay, so if I divide with delta x, my order of accuracy now will be nothing but delta x square. And over here, this y term is also having order of accuracy delta y square. So I have to write complete order as delta x square delta y square. Okay, so now this will become del square u divided by del x del y at point I comma j. If you try to see in the denominator, we will be getting 4 times delta x delta y. Okay, and in the numerator, we will be having u at point I plus 1 comma j plus 1 minus u at point I plus 1 comma j minus 1 minus of u at I minus 1 comma j plus 1, and minus minus will become plus of u at point I minus 1 comma j minus 1. Okay, so this is how we can, and plus we will be having order as delta x square and delta y square. So this is how we can determine the second order accurate central difference approximation for our mixed derivative term. Okay, now after mixed derivative, there is one important aspect, and that is related to the treatment of boundary nodes. Okay, so another important aspect is related to the treatment of boundary nodes. Is there any issue in the previous equation? Anyone is having any doubt? Okay, so let me now talk about treatment of boundary nodes. In case of treatment of boundary nodes, let us consider that we are having some situation where our domain is fixed at this point. So this is say our boundary, and say boundary node is given by some number 1. And then I have some grid over here, and say this is my node number 2, this is my node number 3. Okay, now say what I am having, this distance over here is delta y, and this distance over here is actually delta y square. Okay, so this is what I am having. Now you can see, say if I have to calculate del u by del y at point number 1, so how I can write del u by del y at point number 1? I can apply over here forward difference approximation, and considering forward difference approximation, my del u by del y will be becoming u at point 2 minus u at point 1 divided by delta y. And what will be my order of accuracy? Order of accuracy will be nothing but delta y. Okay, so now there are actually two challenges. What are the challenges? That if I am considering for all my internal nodes, say node number 2, node number 3, and so on up to say other nodes, I am having 4, 5, 6, if I am considering second order accurate central difference scheme for all my internal nodes, and for my boundary node, if I consider a first order accurate scheme, what will be happening? Because information will be propagating from boundary to the core of the domain. So that's why whatever the highest order of accuracy we have taken, if we are not considering equivalent order of accuracy for the boundary node, then our accuracy of solution within the entire simulation domain will be sacrificed. Is this point clear? So what I am trying to say, that if for all the internal nodes we are considering say second order accurate scheme, okay, and for the boundary node, if I consider the first order accurate scheme, obviously while the solution will be propagating within the entire simulation domain, that will be affected by the solution at the boundary node. So that's why our entire order of accuracy will be suffering. Okay, so that's why what we want to do, in order to achieve the second order accurate throughout the domain, we have to consider our boundary also, treatment of the boundary node also second order accurate. Okay, so now if you try to apply over here central difference scheme at point 1, you will be finding that you are having one node within the domain, but when you have to move in the backward direction, you are not having any domain. Okay, so say you have to go to some point 2 dash, and that point 2 dash is actually outside the domain. So obviously, if this point 2 dash is outside the domain, we don't know about value of this field parameter u at particular at this point 2 dash. Okay, so it means we cannot apply over here point. We cannot apply over here central difference scheme. So earlier days, what was done? Some sort of extrapolation or another thing. What was done? Whatever the value of field variable was at point number 2, same value was assigned at point number 2 dash, and this type of condition was called as reflection type boundary condition. And considering this reflection type boundary condition, actually central difference treatment was applied, but this scheme was not very much accurate. Okay, so that's why people have come up with the idea that instead of moving in backward direction, we can move in the forward direction itself, and instead of only including the two node points, we can increase the number of node points which are participating in the solution of boundary node and making our scheme as higher order accurate. Okay, so to do so, what we will be doing, we will be moving with some another technique for finding out the derivative terms in terms of finite differences, and that technique is known as polynomial approximation. Okay, so what we will be doing, this technique is known as actually polynomial approximation technique. So what we will be doing, we will be considering some polynomial over here for my output field variable. So let me consider that u is my output field variable. So let me consider second order polynomial for this one. So if I consider second order polynomial, I can write u as nothing but say some constant a plus b times of y plus c times of y square. Okay, so what I have done, I have written some polynomial approximation for my field variable u. Okay, and in this polynomial approximation, if you see how many constants I am having, this a, b and c are my constants. Okay, so I am having actually three constants. Now if I consider that at my boundary node y is equal to 0 and y is moving in this positive direction, so in that case what will be happening, if I have three constants, I require value of this field variable at three different nodal points in order to determine the value of constants a, b and c. Okay, so now what I will be doing, let me call that value of field variable at point 1 is u1, at point 2 is u2, and at point 3 is u3. So now in this particular equation, if I substitute y equal to 0, so at y equal to 0, what is our node point? You can see u is nothing but u1. So if I substitute this boundary condition, I will be getting u1 is equal to a. Okay, so this one constant I have got, that my a constant is nothing but equal to u1. Then next, what I can do, I can consider that at y equal to delta y, u is u2. Okay, so here I will be getting u2 will be equal to, in place of a, now I will be writing u1 plus b times delta y plus c times of delta y square. Similarly, if I consider at y is equal to 2 delta y, what I will be getting, u will be my u3. So I'll be getting u3 will be equal to u1 plus b into 2 delta y plus c times 4 delta y square. Okay, so now can you solve these equation number 2 and 3 for finding out the values of b and c? All of you please solve it and let me know what we are getting the value of b and c. I am also trying over here. So from equation number 2, I can write u2 minus u1 equal to, so this is I am writing from 2, u2 minus u1 equal to b times delta y plus c times delta y square. And from equation number 3, I can write u3 minus u1 equal to, now let me take two common over here. So if I take two common, I will be dividing in the left hand side by 2, and over here I will be getting b times delta y plus, or let me take directly, let me take 4 as common. Okay, so if I take 4 as common over here, here I will be getting b delta y by 2, and here I will be getting nothing but c into delta y square. So say this is my equation number 4, this is my equation number 5. Now which operation I will be applying? I will be applying now operation 4 minus 5. So if I do 4 minus 5 over here, so I will be able to get the value of b. So from here I will be getting u2 minus u1 minus of u3 minus u1 by 4. Okay, that will be equal to what we are having, b delta y minus b delta y by 2, and c term will be cancelling. Okay, so this will be becoming b into delta y divided by 2. So from here you can see I will be getting 4 times of u2, and this 4 u1 plus u1, it will be becoming minus 3 times of u1, and over here I will be getting minus u3 divided by 4, and that will be equal to b into delta y by 2. So from here if you see, we are getting value of b as equal to minus 3 u1 plus 4 u2 and minus u3 divided by 2 delta y. So why I have calculated value of b only? Because I am mainly interested in b only. Why I am interested in b, let me tell you. So I have told you earlier that u is a plus by plus cy square. Okay, and I am interested in finding the value of del u by del y at point number 1. So you can see del u by del y will be a plus b, sorry, a will be becoming 0. So del u by del y, if you take, that will be b plus 2cy, and if I am calculating this at point number 1, at point number 1, y will be equal to 0, and finally I will be finding that del u by del y at point number 1 is nothing but equal to b. And b I have just now calculated as minus 3 times u1 plus 4 times u2 minus u3 divided by 2 times of delta y. Okay, so this is how I can actually, by including the more number of nodes in the forward direction, so instead of only 2 nodes 1 and 2, I have included one more node 3 in the forward direction, and this has given us actually more higher order accurate term. But how to check the order of accuracy of this particular term? So that, let me tell you. So what we will be doing for checking the order of accuracy, let me write expression of ui. So ui will be nothing but equal to u plus del u by del y into y plus del square u divided by del y square into y square divided by 2 factorial. So this is how, like, I can write the Taylor series approximation if I have to calculate this at u plus some u as a function of y. Okay, so now if I compare this equation with my approximation a plus by plus c into y square, can you tell me how many number of terms we are taking in our Taylor series expression? So if you see over here, we are considering, if we consider the equivalence of these two equations, we are considering nothing but up to 3 terms in our Taylor series expansion. So if we are considering 3 terms, it means we are neglecting the term which is having power y2 power 3. So it means this equation u is equal to a plus by plus cy square is nothing but third order accurate. Okay, so this equation over here is nothing but third order accurate. But while we have calculated del u by del y, so in the del u by del y, if you see the expression which I have got, that is actually minus 3 u1 plus 4 u2 minus u3 divided by 2 times of delta y. So here if you see, in the numerator we are having all the terms involving u1, u2 and u3. So u1, u2, u3 is nothing but can be directly obtained from this expression. So that's why I can say that my numerator over here is third order accurate. Okay, so numerator over here is third order accurate. And then in the denominator, actually, I am dividing overall term by delta y. So if I am dividing overall term by delta y, so my final order of accuracy will be what? It will be nothing but delta y square. Okay. So is this point clear? So what we have done over here, we have whatever the polynomial expression we have considered, that we have made equivalent to that of our Taylor series expansion, and we have tried to compare from the Taylor series expansion that how many number of terms we are neglecting, and considering that we are trying, we have seen over here that order of accuracy of del u by del y has become nothing but 2. So it means when we are increasing the participation of more number of nodes, that is actually helping us in increasing the order of accuracy. However, what will be happening with increase in the participation, obviously our solution will be becoming more complex. Okay. Now, what is the need for these higher order derivative terms? So one need already I established, that if we are considering the higher order accurate scheme for our internal nodes, our boundary nodes should also have equivalent order. Okay. Another important point is, when we are interested in fluid flow and heat transfer problem, apart from calculating the flow field within the entire domain, we are mainly interested in calculation of wall shear stress also over our objects. Why we are interested in wall shear stress? Because that helps us in calculating the value of drag. Okay. And once we are obtaining the value of drag over some certain surface, it helps us in designing the system for our applications. Similarly, if we talk about heat transfer systems, in case of heat transfer systems, we are interested in determining the heat flux at the boundaries. Okay, because heat flux at the boundaries will be helping us in designing many of the heat transfer systems. So that's why in our fluid mechanics and heat transfer, we are having two very, very important parameters of interest. One of the parameter of interest is shear stress, whose definition is tau equal to mu times del u by tau equal to mu times del u by del y, and this del u by del y we are calculating at wall. Okay. And another parameter of interest we are having, if you see, we know that heat flux, say q double dash, I am writing for heat flux, q double dash we write as nothing but minus k times del t by del y. Okay, so this del t by del y also we write at wall. So it means this heat flux and shear stress are two very, very important parameters which helps us in design of the fluid flow and heat transfer systems. So we are not only interested in determining the value of flow parameters within our simulation domain, but we are also interested in accurate prediction of the wall shear stress and heat flux, which are important parameters from system design point of view. So if you see, the definition of shear stress and definition of heat flux involve del u by del y, so single derivative. Here also we are having single derivative, and this single derivative is actually calculated at the wall. Okay, so if we have to obtain the accurate value of shear stress and accurate value of heat flux, what we have to do, we have to consider higher order approximation terms for the boundary nodes. Okay, so this is one important point, and this is one important criteria why we want to go for higher order derivative terms at higher order approximations at the boundary nodes. Okay, any confusion?
Hello sir.
Yes.
Sir, can you please show the previous slide? Yes, sir. Sir, when we have considered the points in the central part of the domain, as we were increasing the differential term, our order of accuracy were increasing, sir. And sir, at the boundary, when we are taking the points at the boundary, we are seeing that by increasing the differential term, or we can say du by del y or del square u by del y square, if we want to find, then its order of accuracy, sir, is decreasing kind of, because sir, you have written in the next slide, sir. Yes, sir, in this delta y. Yes, sir.
It is not decreasing. You see what we have done, u plus del u by del y plus del square u by del y square. So if we have considered up to this, if you recall to our earlier approximations, when we have considered up to second point, our actually order of accuracy was 2 only. So here also, while we are considering up to this, for del u by del y, order of accuracy is 2. Okay. So you once again like relook into the previous things which we have derived for central difference scheme. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank
you. Okay. So now our next part is, let me also give you some idea about non-uniform grids. So what will happen with non-uniform grids? Okay, so it is not always true that we have to go for the uniform grid only. We can go with the non-uniform grid also. Obviously, while we will be writing some numerical algorithm or numerical code, that process actually, it will be complicating if we are having non-uniform grid. Okay, but we can proceed with the non-uniform grid. Only one limitation of finite difference method is there, that we cannot proceed with unstructured grid in case of finite difference method. Okay, wherever if our grid is structured, whether it is uniform or non-uniform, actually we can apply the finite difference approximation. Okay, so let me now consider some non-uniform grid over here. So this is my, say, two-dimensional domain x, y. Say I have some point over here p, and this point p is having indices I comma j. Okay, and it is having location, say, x I. Now I have considered some point in the right hand side, and say coordinate of this point is x I plus 1, and indices of this point are I plus 1 comma j. And I have considered one more point in the left hand side. So you can see the point in the left hand side is having say location x I minus 1 and indices as I minus 1 comma j. So you can clearly see I have drawn over here the distance between the different node points is actually not same. Okay, so here I am calling this distance as delta xi, where delta xi is x at point I plus 1 minus x at point I, and this distance over here I am calling as delta xi minus 1, and this delta xi minus 1 is nothing but x at point I minus x at point I minus 1. Okay, so you can clearly see over here our delta xi and delta xi minus 1 are different. Okay, now what I will be doing, I will try to obtain the value of field parameter at point I plus 1 comma j with reference to point P by applying Taylor series expression. Okay, so if I apply Taylor series expression, I will be getting u at point I plus 1 comma j as u at point I comma j plus delta x I times of del u by del x at point I comma j. Okay, then I have to consider over here plus delta x I whole square divided by 2 factorial into del square u by del x square at point I comma j plus delta x I cube divided by 3 factorial into del cube u by del x cube at point I comma j plus so on up to like this. Okay, similarly, if I write u I minus 1 comma j with reference to I comma j, I can write, now if you see, when I am moving from this point to this point, now distance between the two is delta x I minus 1. Okay, so when the distance is delta x I minus 1, I can write over here delta x I minus 1, and there too I am moving in the negative direction, so I have to put over here negative sign. Okay, into del u by del x at point I comma j, then I can write delta x I minus 1 with negative sign whole square divided by 2 factorial into del square u divided by del x square at point I comma j plus delta x I minus 1 with negative sign cube divided by 3 factorial into del cube u divided by del x cube plus so on up to like this. Okay, now if I add these two equations, what I will be getting. Okay, so what I am doing now, I am adding. What I will be getting after addition, I will be getting u at point I plus 1 comma j plus u at point I minus 1 comma j, and while adding I will take this uij term to the left hand side. So if I take to left hand side, I can write minus 2 ui comma j. Now this first order derivative will be canceling. No, it will not cancel. Now you can see what we are having. We have now one as delta x I and another as delta x I minus 1. So it will not cancel now. So what I will be getting, delta x I minus of delta x I minus 1 times del u by del x at point I comma j, and plus say I am neglecting all the higher order terms. So if I am neglecting all the higher order terms, still let me write the first term. So what I will be having, first term del x I square plus del x I minus 1 square divided by 2 factorial, okay, into del square u divided by del x square, and this I am calculating at I plus I comma j plus so on up to something like this. Okay, so like this I will be getting now the multiple terms. So here you can see, while I will be actually obtaining these, if I have to get the order of accuracy, if I have to obtain the second order term, okay, let me do one thing, because while I am simply adding, in that case what is happening, I am getting del u by del x term also, and I am getting del square u by del x square term also. Okay, so let me apply some operation which will be actually canceling one of the term. Okay, so either I can cancel del u by del x, or I can cancel del square u by del x square, because I will try to calculate the derivative of only a single term so that we can comment about the order. Okay, so to do so, what I will be doing, I will apply one more operation. I will apply this, say this is my equation number one. So say this first equation is my equation number one, and this second equation is my equation number two. So I will apply one operation. I will multiply equation number one first with delta x I minus one. Okay. So what I am doing, first equation I am multiplying with which term? Delta x I minus one. So if I do so, what I will be getting? Delta x I minus one times u I plus one comma j. That will be equal to delta x I minus 1 times u I comma j plus delta x I into delta x I minus 1 del u by del x at point I comma j plus so on up to like this. And now second equation I will multiply with delta x I. So if I do second equation into delta x I, what I will be getting? Delta xi times of u minus 1 comma j, that will be equal to delta xi times of ui comma j. Okay, and then over here I will be getting minus of delta xi into delta xi minus 1 del u by del x at point I comma j plus so on up to like this. Okay, so what will be happening over here, this is say my equation number three, this is my equation number four. If now I add three and four, what will be happening? Can you tell me, if I now add equation number 3 and 4, what I will be getting?
First order terms will cancel out.
Yes, first order terms will be canceling out. Can you tell me the final expression which I will be getting? I will be getting delta x at point I minus 1 into u at point I plus 1 comma j, okay, plus delta x I into u at point I minus 1 comma j. This I will be getting in the left hand side, and in the right hand side, what I will be having? These terms, while we will be adding, we will be getting delta xi plus delta xi minus 1 into uij. So this will be my first term. And what other term I will be getting? Plus, now if you see in the second order term, earlier we were having delta xi square, and with delta xi square, we have actually multiplied delta xi minus 1. Okay. So I will be having delta xi square into delta xi minus 1. Okay. And along with this, what I will be getting? Plus delta xi minus 1 square into delta xi divided by 2 into del square u divided by del x square. Is this term clear? How I have got this one? Anyone is having any confusion? Now, if you see third term, what you will be getting in the third term? Can you tell me what will be the third order term now? It will be del xi cube, del xi cube into del xi minus 1 minus of del xi minus 1 cube into del xi divided by 3 factorial into del cube u divided by del x cube plus so on up to. Is this point clear? So from here, if you see, I can write, if I neglect this third order accurate term, I can write this del square u divided by del x square as at point I comma j. This will be becoming nothing but equal to del x at point I minus 1 at u at I plus 1 comma j plus del x at point I into u at I minus 1 comma j minus of delta x I plus delta xi minus 1 times uij divided by, if you see in the denominator, we will be getting this entire term. So this entire term will be delta xi, and delta xi minus 1 I will be taking common outside, and inside I will be getting delta xi minus delta xi minus 1, and overall we will be getting divided by 2. Is this point clear? And plus, if you now see what is the order of accuracy over here, while we will be multiplying, while we will be dividing with this entire term, you can see we are having multiplication power 3 over here and multiplied by this. So overall power is actually how much? In this del cube u by del x cube, if you see the overall power of delta x, including both, overall power is 4. Okay. And while we are considering this second order term with which we are dividing, here it is having overall power as 3. So what is the order of accuracy over here?
1.
So I am getting order of accuracy as nothing but delta x. Okay. So this is how we can actually, what we have done, we have applied central difference approximation for the second order term on a non-uniform grid. And while we did it for the non-uniform grid, we found that our order of accuracy has become 1 for central difference scheme. Now, if I consider that in place of non-uniform, if I have uniform grid, what I have to do? Delta xi, I have to consider equal to delta x I minus 1, say equal to delta x. Now what will be happening? Can you tell me? Can you tell me from the previous slide? So now del square u by del x square at point I comma j will be equal to this delta x I minus 1 and delta x I, everything will be becoming delta x. So this delta x plus delta x, it will be becoming 2, and 1 delta x I can remove with this one. So that's why I will be getting u at point I plus 1 comma j minus plus u at point I minus 1 comma j minus 2 uij, and in the denominator you can see we will be simply getting this delta x, I think somewhere I have done mistake. This has to be plus. This has to be plus over here. Yeah. So if I take this delta x plus delta x, that will be becoming 2 delta x. 2 will be cancelling out, and 1 delta x from here is already removed. So I'll be getting in the denominator finally as 2 times of delta x square. Is this point clear or any confusion? So whatever I have written in the previous slide, what you have to do in that, you have to simply substitute that delta x I equal to delta x I minus 1, and that is equal to delta x. So if you apply some algebraic manipulations, you will be finding this expression. Now let me tell you how the order will be increasing. So when you will be considering this particular term, then this, whatever this coefficient we are having with del cube u by del x cube, this coefficient over here will be becoming nothing but equal to, can you tell me what will be this coefficient when we are considering delta x I and delta x I minus 1 equal?
0.
So this coefficient will be becoming 0, and we will be going to the next term, which is having one more higher power. So if we are having one more higher power, so order of accuracy will be becoming nothing but equal to delta x square. Okay. So from here, we have derived one important conclusion. So you can see first thing that non-uniform mesh actually creates additional difficulty. So while we will be writing the numerical algorithm or numerical code, it will be creating lot of complexity. Apart from that, it also decreases the order of accuracy of the finite difference approximation. Okay. So if considering the same scheme, we move from non-uniform grid to the corresponding uniform grid, our order of accuracy will be improving by one order. Okay. So that is one important conclusion which we have seen over here. Now I will stop at this point, and we will have further discussion in our next lecture. So if you are having any quick questions, that you can